We've been working hard to help the global response to COVID-19. From the start, when we announced our first collaboration in February, we've been clear that several vaccines will be needed and that the best way GSK could help was to use our adjuvant technology to help develop multiple vaccines. We know our adjuvant technology is proven in a pandemic situation, and as well as improving efficacy, it can help reduce the amount of antigen needed and enable more vaccine doses to be made. The vaccine business has pulled out all the stops to respond, and we've committed to make 1 billion doses of adjuvant available next year. To give you some idea of the scale of this response, that's more than we make in all our other vaccines combined on an annual basis, as one of the world's largest vaccine producers. I'm pleased we've today announced that, subject to final contract, we've agreed to supply the UK government with up to 60 million doses of the Sanofi GSK vaccine. We're also in active discussions with the European Union and the US government about supply arrangements, and in addition, plan to make a significant proportion of our total capacity available to the global initiative, Access to COVID-19 Tools, or the ACT Accelerator. One consequence of the COVID crisis has been the acceleration in and focus on new vaccine technology. And we announced a deal with CureVac last week because it gives us access to cutting-edge mRNA technology, which adds to our own in-house research in this area, and we'll work together to develop vaccines against a range of pathogens. Beyond vaccines, we're also making good progress with two promising therapeutic antibody options. One through our collaboration with Vir Biotechnology, which is going to start a phase 2 study next month, and the other, our own pipeline asset, otilimab, where we hope to have a phase 2A proof of concept results in Q1 next year.